Tonight, weighing the balance between protecting the state's 2,800 registered sex offenders and protecting our children.
And finding that balance was what several state lawmakers were talking about today in Augusta. News 8's Michelle Frey joins us live from the Capitol with tonight's top story. Good evening, Michelle.
Good evening, Tori. Inside the state capitol building behind me, the Joint Standing Committee on Criminal Justice and Public Safety today was looking at possible changes to the state's sex offender registry, and they have several things to consider, including the possibility of implementing a new federal law and whether or not our current state law is even constitutional.
This isn't just a yes or no kind of matter. We have a duty to protect the public, but we also have, on the other hand, the duty to ensure that sex offenders who have done their time and who have complied with the law don't get killed.
Commissioner of Public Safety Ann Jordan is referencing the 2006 killings of two registered sex offenders. Police believe their killer tracked them down through Maine's online registry. That's one reason this meeting drew Jordan and members of the state legislature today, trying to gather information on ways to make Maine's online sex offender registry safer and more effective.
Under Adam Walsh.
One way to beef it up, comply with a new federal law.
Well, the Adam Walsh Act, a new federal law, is considerably different than what Maine has.
Under the federal law, sex offenders would be on a three-tier system. Lower-risk offenders would be on the public registry 15 years, the next tier 25. Those at the highest risk to reoffend, on for life. Maine's registry currently has two tiers, 10 years and life. The penalty for not complying, losing 10% of a grant used to support the Maine Drug Enforcement Agency, but
it could end up costing the state of Maine much more than the penalty for not complying.
Our staff is on mandatory 45-hour work weeks as it is, just to keep their heads above water, and we obviously would need to have additional staff.
To the tune of $200,000 to $300,000 a year, something that may cause this committee to pass on the federal law and come up with their own compromise.
Our bottom line is we want a system that works, that's constitutional, that's fair, and that those will be our guidelines. And if that means differing from the federal law to meet those three goals, then we'll do it.
The constitutionality of the Maine Sex Offender Registry is being challenged in the courts. The Maine Constitution promises life, liberty, safety, and happiness, whereas the federal Constitution says life, liberty, and happiness. So it's that safety factor that's adding an extra layer for legislators here who will likely wait to see what the Maine Supreme Court decides next year before deciding on whether or not to implement that Walsh law, which they have to make a decision on by 2009. Live in Augusta, I'm Michelle Frey, News 8, WMTW.